is the Palin Update on Mama Grizzly Radio. I'm Kevin Shola in the 3D Security and Training Academy studios.
I'll use this ground moose and caribou just like you would hamburger. And then the best hot dogs in the world are these made out of moose meat.
A former pageant participant who's an avid hunter and a great American. Sounds like Sarah Palin. But we're talking about our special guest today. Teresa Vail is here. The former Miss America contestant and bow hunter is here to talk about her brand new TV show that will air on Outdoor Channel. It's called Limitless with Teresa Vail. Sarah Palin highlights the good that's come out of Baltimore, as well as the slap heard around the world. A brand new installment of Liberty and Legacy with Tamara Colbert is on the way from Texas. And just ahead, our latest edition of Steel Resolve with Sarah Steelman in Missouri. Welcome to the Palin Update on Mama Grizzly Radio. The Palin Update is sponsored by 3D Security and Training Academy. Learn more at 3DSTA.com. Now our special guest, she was Miss Kansas and a contestant in the Miss America pageant, a hunter, and a sergeant in the Army National Guard, and now she has a brand new TV show. We welcome Teresa Vail to the Palin Update on Mama Grizzly Radio. Hi, Teresa. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
Great. Thanks for being on the program with us.
And absolutely. Thanks for asking.
You know, this is a woman whose Twitter account says dog mom, God, guns, and country. So right there, what's not to like? I'm sold.
Well, thanks a lot. Yeah, the dog sells everybody.
Yeah, how's Sarge doing?
Oh, he's awesome. He's here chewing on his deer antler.
Now, there you go. Another spoiled animal. So let's tell everybody about what a little tiny dog Sarge is and how little he's going to stay, right?
Yeah. So Sarge is 8 months right now, and he's 95 pounds. he's an African Mastiff, and his dad was 170 pounds. So he's still got a ways to grow.
That is amazing. You know, it's funny, our puppy now, he's a lab mix, but he has the little feet, so, you know, he's going to stay whatever the heck he's mixed with instead of bigger. And when my kids see a big dog in the park that's a puppy, you know, they're little now, but I say, look at those feet, look at those monster feet.
Oh, yeah, the feet tell everything. And Sarge, he's still grown into him, but he's my travel companion and my hunting buddy, and he goes everywhere I go.
Well, he is adorable. Now, you have a new show coming up on Outdoor Channel, and it really looks interesting, and it looks like a lot of things are going to be happening on it. It's called Limitless with Teresa Vail. Can you tell everybody a little bit about it? What's it about, and what will you be doing on it?
Sure. So it's a combination of a hunting show and an extreme adventure show. We wanted to do something totally different because Outdoor Channel has never had a sole female host before. And so when they found me and we were, you know, talking about what I do and what I've done, I've always tried to do things out of the box. That's my repertoire. That's what I do. And so we came up with a hunting show and putting a spin on it with this cool adventure stuff. So a couple weeks ago, to our Wyoming deer hunt, we're tying climbing Devil's Tower, which is right there in Wyoming. Do you know what Devil's Tower is?
Yeah, is that the this is a place where people are not supposed to climb, right?
Well, they can climb it.
Yes. Or they may climb it.
Yeah, they can, if they can try.
Right.
Just about 1,000 people try to climb this monument every year, so it's not very popular. It's like 1,500 feet of vertical cliff, vertical rock. And I got to tell you, it is the most extreme, the most challenging thing I've ever done. And so stuff like that, it's this awesome stuff that we get to tie to our hunting stories, and it makes sense. It's just the coolest thing I've ever done. I'm so thankful that Outdoor Channel has given me a chance, and they've put faith in me to do this. And it's just been a dream come true.
Well, I mean, that is amazing. I mean, here you are. You said the first woman who's been the only host of the show, and instead of just, you know, going on those merits, they're having you do really extreme things as well.
I know, but I love it, and I wouldn't change it for anything. The closer to death I can get, the better.
Now, you said you like to do things out of the box, and it's funny because I think that's another thing you have in common with Governor Palin. I think you have a lot of things in common with her, actually, because of your pageant history and of your love of hunting. You're more with mm-hmm. the bow, where she's more with the gun, but, mm-hmm. you know, both two women who love the outdoors and two women, I think, who really have a common sense attitude about them. So, you know, that's something that, you know, strikes us right away when we look at your resume and we look at hers. And, you know, it's funny, you look at the pageant history, and yours is very unique for many reasons. You being one of the first pageant members to, you know, show a tattoo in a competition on a big stage. But, you know, we've had a lot of pageant winners and also contestants on this show, Angela Baracchio and Tara Conner, Erica Harold, of course, who ran for Congress, and Brenda Sharman. I mean, the list goes on. And, you know, what's interesting, you talk to these women, there's so many stereotypes about people who've been involved in pageants, but every single one I've talked to, I mean, you don't get, you know, more intelligent people and hardworking because those pageants are, and you just talked about climbing a mountain that most of us would be scared of doing, but I tell you what you did, you know, in some ways is probably a little more courageous than that, to go out there and expose yourself figuratively and literally, and what you've done before. Yeah. So let's talk a little bit about that. How did the pageant life for you, being Miss Kansas, and also just all of the steps you had to take to do that, help you in the things you're doing now? It's got to give you a lot of confidence.
Oh, my gosh, absolutely. For one, it did teach me to perfect my public speaking and how to be diplomatic, how to not step on too many toes, not offend too many people, yet still get my opinion out there. And that is essential for this industry, being in the outdoor industry. You get a lot of anti-hunters, a lot of anti-gun people. And so just knowing how to work with them instead of attacking them back, which is what a lot of people want to do.
Yeah.
So it taught me that and gave me just the confidence to pursue things that maybe I wouldn't have tried before.
And, you know, we mentioned the tattoos, and that made a lot of national news. But, you know, you weren't the usual participant in other ways, too. You have military experience. You love guns. You speak Chinese. You're not your run-of-the-mill pageant member.
I had a rough upbringing, and it forced me to do my own thing. I didn't have friends. I was a social pariah. And so it forced me to, you know, start learning Chinese and join the army and do things that I really want to do and not be influenced by maybe bad friend groups like a lot of people get sucked into in their teenage years.
You know, it's funny you say that. That's something else I've noticed with a lot of, you know, Miss America contestants and even winners or Miss USA and other things. People think like, oh, here comes the pretty girl, everything handed to her. And a lot of times
y'all were
ostracized more than you would think the stereotypical person would be.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I really wish more people would give us credit and listen to our stories instead of just thinking, oh, you know, she's pretty, so she's gotten everything handed to her whole entire life. That is not the case at all. I assure you, I have worked for everything I've ever had.
Well, usually when I hear that, I mean, it comes from a woman who looks like John Lovitz or something along those lines. So I just, you know, I said that, you didn't. So how would you say, any idea how to say Mama Grizzly Radio or maybe Sarah Palin in Chinese? I mean, is there...
I don't. I know more formal Chinese.
Okay. Now, your military career, I mean, that's the thing. Thank you, first of all, for your service. And here you are, you know, running for, when you were running for Miss Kansas and all the other things you've done, I mean, that's something that had to open a lot of doors for you. Why did you get involved in the National Guard? And tell us about that experience a little bit. You're a sergeant.
Sure. Yeah. So my dad served for 33 years. And he is my hero. He's my inspiration, my influence. And as a young girl, I just wanted to do everything that Daddy did. And so when I was 17, there are 9 of us kids, and I'm number 6. So he has paid for 5 kids' colleges. And when it came to be my turn, I thought, you know what? I can't do that to Dad. I can't make him spend all that money again. So I decided to join sooner than I really wanted to. I wanted to wait until after college, but I decided to join early at 17 and have them pay for school, and it just worked out perfectly. And I've been in 8 years now. It's something that I love doing. I love putting on that uniform and helping other soldiers. It's definitely a life changer, and it taught me to grow up very, very quickly.
And I know your dad means so much to you. You just mentioned that too, and you also say he's your first and best hunting buddy.
He is. follow all my tweets, don't you?
I have for the interview, yeah. Well, listen, I got to admit, I'm looking at the Sarge pictures more than anything else.
I know. That's why I put them up. I want to see Sarge more than anything.
Oh, that is great. Well, Theresa, we wish you the best of luck with this show. And, you know, you mentioned Devil's Tower. Other things that she'll be doing on the show, she'll be on the coast of British Columbia in search of grizzlies. Speaking of Mama Grizzly Radio, she's going to harvest.
It's actually Alaska.
Oh, okay. Oh, even better. Look at that.
Yeah, that's in 2 weeks.
You're going to harvest your first elk in New Mexico and skydive with the West Point Parachute Team. I mean, this sounds great. Woman, man, whoever's doing this, I mean, this is tremendous. Outdoor Channel. People have to check it out. And it starts when?
It starts July 2nd. That's premiere date.
All right. Tremendous. Well, Theresa Vail, we are looking forward to it. And if people want to find out more about this, they could follow you on Twitter, right?
Oh, that's correct. Yeah. Or Facebook, Instagram. I have it all.
All right. Theresa Vail, thank you so much for being with us. And we wish you the best of luck with the show. We will be watching and we hope you'll join us again soon and keep spoiling that little dog of yours.
Thanks a lot, Kevin.
Okay, thanks so much. For more on the brand new show, Limitless, with Theresa Vail, head to OutdoorChannel.com.